Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's episode, we're gonna talk about candy cabs. That's right, candy cabs. What are they? In Japan, they didn't actually stand up to play games, they sat down. So behind me is a bunch of those and I'm gonna show them to you right now. All right, so right now in front of me, you're looking at what's the Sega Blast City. So a lot of times they had various different arcade boards in there. Actually, that one's open. Maybe we can look at it later on. But these are the Sega Blast City. Here's the Versus City. They've got so many of them here, actually. There's two more Versus Cities. These are really cool, really, really cool systems. But you know, what's funny is some of these companies try to model these, you know, their arcades based on candy cabs, and oftentimes it falls short because people aren't really into that as much in the US. It's a little bit niche. But see, over here, there's even more of them. These are called Vuelix cabinets. These actually typically have widescreen displays, more modern games. That one's running, I think, Street Fighter 4. So you can see they're kind of neat because they're pretty slim in design. But again, you sit down to play, so there's like kind of the comfort aspect of it. It's got two speakers up there and sometimes two speakers down there. It's usually got a lit up control panel where you can put in the instruction card of the game you're playing. That one doesn't have it. Here's a couple more of the older style ones. This is the Neo Candy by SNK. Really cool. I don't know that one. I'm not as familiar with all of these, but there's so many different ones that were released. Here's a whole section of Vuelix games. Now keep in mind, these Vuelix cabinets, they come in various different types. That's a Vuelix L. Oh my gosh, they've got Shredder's Revenge on these. That is really cool. Okay, I'm gonna have to check that out later. That is awesome. There's a Blast City right there, so we'll take a closer look. So you got your player one, player two, and this is where you'd put your instruction card for the game. Very large CRT right in your face. So fun to play these. These are the Sammy Atomos Wave systems. So I've had a couple of these in the past. Very, very cool systems. That one's running Demolish Fist, which is a really fun game that I love. There's a Astro City right there. I always loved this display right there. This, it says it's a 29 inch monitor. I don't think it's quite 29, but it's very large and it's right in your face, which is awesome. And then over here we have several more. There's the Astro City, but the cool thing about these cabinets as well is in any of these cabinets, you have the ability to turn the screen both vertical or horizontal. Now it doesn't, you know, it doesn't pop out and do that. You have to actually disassemble the cabinet, but it is fairly easy to disassemble that. And there's another Blast City. So it's really cool to be at a show like this and see these cabinets so well represented. And a lot of people enjoy them, you know? So maybe it's not only Japan that likes to sit down and play, because check this out, there's a lot of people over here playing right now on their candy cabs. So this one, actually, I've never seen this one before. That's very, very cool. But yeah, there's a ton of them. I've never seen this one before. You know, I'm not definitely not an expert at these. I've owned one. I owned a Blast City. But yeah, fun systems. There's a lot of versatility to them. A lot of people will run things like they'll buy modern ones. So they'll buy one, not modern ones. They'll buy one in modern times and they'll put like a Mr. Cade in it or something like that. And then they have more versatility, or even a Naomi, and netboot it for multiple options. I did a video on the channel about netbooting your Naomi. There's a lot of solutions. So anyways, I just wanted to give you guys a quick look at candy cabs. Do I think any of the home arcade companies will develop a candy cab design? I don't know. It's a little hard to do it with the materials because it's plastic and metal, and you can't do it with wood. They're not made out of wood. I don't think it would go over as well, but we'll see. Anyways, put in your comments below what you feel about candy cabs. Do you enjoy these? Do you like these? Do you have one? Do you want to get one? I will say, from owning one, parts availability is a little tough sometimes when you're working on them. But anyways, if you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and we will see you on the next one.